Today we're looking at singers' most popular versus most critically acclaimed songs. Here we got Beyoncé's most popular song, Halo.
Remember those walls I built? Well, baby, they're tumbling down. And they didn't even put up a fight. They didn't even make the sound.
I always say this, but I love how pitchy that is, the sound thing. It just works so well. It's a mood.
Every rule I had you breaking, it's the risk that I'm taking. I ain't never gonna shut you out.
I feel like we listened to this song a lot on this channel recently. I'm surprised this is Beyoncé's most popular song. She's got so many, right?
Baby, I can see your halo. You know you're my
It's also a ballad. How common is that a singer's most popular song is a ballad? Ed Sheeran pretty much only makes ballad, and Shape of You, that is not a ballad, it's his most famous song. And here we got Beyoncé's most critically acclaimed song called Crazy in Love featuring Jay-Z.
I look so deep in your eyes. I touch you more and more.
That dancing's so sick. I love that in between of rapping and singing. Like, it's so rhythmic, it's so fast and interesting, but it's still singing. I love it. Hype song. Cool music video, too. That is so awesome. I forgot how good that song is. So here's a quote from a critic. There are some songs that you just know immediately are going to be timeless, that instantly signal the arrival of a major musical force to be reckoned with. And if Crazy in Love doesn't fit this bill, I have no idea what would. I thought he was gonna say, if Crazy in Love doesn't fit this bill, I have no taste. That's a funny thing to say as a critic, because of course that is true about all critics. To some people, every critic will have bad taste. I, for example, respect Anthony Fantano's opinion. However, I do not think that he is right. I think I know better. I think everyone thinks they know better. It's like when you guys are angry with me in the comments. That one has to go to the critically acclaimed. By the way, welcome back to another daily video. My name is Joel from Roomie Official, and we have defined the most popular song as the one with the most Spotify plays, and the most critically acclaimed ones are the ones where we have seen the highest average score in reviews. Next up, we got The Weeknd and his most popular song, Blinding Lights. Have you heard this song? I find it so crazy that this is more popular than Can't Feel My Face. I just think Can't Feel My Face is a better song in every conceivable way. The only thing this song has on Can't Feel My Face is that this has that retro vibe, so maybe your grandma, your mommy, or whatever, want to listen to it a little bit more, because like, yeah, this is what music sounded like when I was not super old. Seems dangerous to dance in the road like that. What are you teaching our kids, Abel? That's his real name, by the way. I know his real name because I am music channel. And here we got The Weeknd's most critically acclaimed song, Can't Feel My Face. Why am I agreeing with the critics and not with how popular things are?
This is weird.
And I know she'll be the death of me. At least we'll both be numb. And she'll always get the best of me. The worst is yet to come.
The only thing that bothers me about this song necessarily is that I feel like they really went for him sounding like Michael Jackson. You know, I think The Weeknd and Michael Jackson have similar voices, but they really went for it 100% with a lot of the types of melodies and the groove and stuff.
We both know we can't.
There's so much suspense in this. There's so little going on, but it's so fun to listen to. Baseline though.
But I love it. But I love it. I can't feel my face when I'm with you.
Those background choirs, Michael Jackson, 100%. And those ad-libs, that's almost an impression. That would work in Michael Jackson impression video. And here's a quote from a critic. Our boy grabbed Max Martin, pop's best radio alchemist, and managed to create a Michael Jackson light song your grandparents will enjoy with lyrics that are about... with Can't Feel My Face, Abel proved you can put The Weeknd in the spotlight, but you can't take away his... Snappy does. Subversive pop perseverance at its best. So yeah, I'm gonna have to give it to the most critically acclaimed song once again. I think I have a thing for songs that can take someone totally unknown and make them known. That's what I define as a good song. Not all the time, Dance Monkey, I'm looking at you. Here we got Taylor Swift and her most popular song, Shake It Off.
I see I'm too late.
This is also Max Martin.
Got nothing.
Max Martin was on the critically acclaimed last time. Now he's on the popular.
But I keep cruising.
It's crazy that there's no bass until the chorus. I think this is a fun type of that video, probably the best one I've seen. But why are there so many artists who are like, yes, I want artsy dancing in my videos. Improvising modern dancing. I don't get it. Anyway, it's a good song. Here we got Taylor Swift's most critically acclaimed song, Blank Space. I would not have thought that. Nice to meet you, where you been? I could show this is basically a rap flow, right? So it's gonna be forever, or it's gonna go down in flames. You can tell me when it's over. So good. That song holds up. Here is the critic quote. The track is a dazzling pop gem in which the singer skewered her own reputation years before she made an entire album about it. For a song that serves as a self-deprecating admission that perception is reality, Blank Space became a truly defining moment for both Swift and the decade in pop. She told GQ that she wrote the song from the perspective of the crazy, but seductive, but glamorous, but nuts, but manipulative woman that the media painted her as. I like that she got in that she's perceived as seductive and glamorous. In there. I'm gonna have to give it to the critically acclaimed songs again. Shake It Off is so upbeat, it gets like weirdly annoying. It's just a lot of repetitive melodies. Haters gonna hate, 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 baby. Players gonna play, 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 baby. I'm just gonna shake. I like Blank Space better. It's just got more of a progression. I think that's Max Martin as well, right? Yep, written by Shellback, Max Martin, and Taylor Swift. Two Swedish men and an American girl. That sounds like an adult, never mind. Here we got Marvin Gaye and his most popular song, Ain't No Mountain High Enough, featuring Tammy Terrell. Ain't no mountain. This is such a classic. Ain't no, low, ain't no river wide enough, baby. Even that vibrato on wide for me is iconic. And I'll ride wide enough, baby. If you need me, call me. No matter where you are, no matter how far. Don't worry, baby. Just call my name. I'll be there in a hurry. You don't have to worry. I was wondering about her facial expression. She almost looked like his breath was bad. Don't worry, baby. Baby, they're just like standing by a phone booth or something? What's going on? Ain't no river wide enough to keep me from getting to you, baby. Such a good song. Here we got Marvin Gaye's most critically acclaimed song called What's Going On? We don't need to escalate. This music video looks new. You see, war is not the answer. For only love can conquer hate. You know. She looks sad. What's Going On is not only Marvin Gaye's masterpiece, but it's the most important and passionate record to come out of soul music, delivered by one of its finest voices, a man finally free to speak his mind, and so move on from R&B frick symbol to true recording artist. I'm gonna have to give it to Ain't No Mountain High. I'm all for artists trying to change the world and everything. I'm really glad What's Going On is a record, but I'm not gonna put it on if I got Ain't No Mountain High Enough. Also, I kinda thought it was the, I said, hey, what's going on? We got Jay-Z and his most popular song, N-Words in Paris, featuring Kanye West. Ah, that beat is stank. I like the beat. I didn't get a great feel for the song. I haven't actually heard that before. And here we got Jay-Z's most critically acclaimed song called 99 Problemas. It was Spanish. I got 99 problems, but a b- ain't one. I this got is so iconic. Patrol on the patrol, foes that want to make sure my clothes. I gotta love when they censor rap lyrics and it's just like a bunch of breaks all the time. I got 99 problems, but a b- ain't one. Hit me. That's so dope. 20 years after his peak, Rick Rubin ended up crafting the best beat of his career with 99 Problems. With a sound straight out of Run DMC's glory days, Jay-Z puts the best storytelling of his career on wax. Yep, gotta give it to Acclaim. A little bit unfair because I hadn't really heard the other song before, but life isn't fair. If life was fair, I would be 6'9". You got Katy Perry and her most popular song, Dark Horse. What about freaking Teenage Dream? I thought Roar was her most popular song. Anyway, let's just listen. So there was this rapper who actually sued her because he had a similar wah, wah, wah. We talked about that in this video. Baby, do you dare to do this? Acting. The makeup's pretty cool. I'm not one to notice makeup, but like it's asymmetrical, so I noticed. Whoever did the makeup, Rumi approves. There's no going back. Oh yeah, that was right when trap drops started being a thing. That is one of the most palatable trap drops though. A lot of the electronic music drops that end up in pop music, it just ages a lot of songs terribly. And here we got Katy Perry's most critically acclaimed song, Teenage Dream. Why do I agree with all the critics? How sentimental and nice is this song? Her voice is so good in this. It's a pretty lame song, but she's got that little edge. I think she's got similarly to Kesha. There's something piercing about her voice in a good way. How good is this production too? So iconic. Katy Perry's anthemic pop savvy is so strong that nothing, not even the knowledge that this song is about Russell Brand, can dampen the heart on sleeve, fist in the air satisfaction of Teenage Dream. What? It's about Russell Brand? Then I dislike. I don't like any songs about Russell Brand. If you told me that Bohemian Rhapsody was about Russell Brand, then it's the worst song of all time. Similar to Madonna's Like a Virgin, this is a song about a love so intense, it makes you shiny and new, timed to the millisecond for pop perfection. That one goes to critically acclaimed as well. I and the critics have good taste. And plebs, you watching that? I'm kidding. Let me know in the comments if you guys agree or if I'm just being an idiot. Here we got Frank Ocean and his most popular song, Thinking About You. A tornado flew around my room before you came. Excuse the mess it made, it usually doesn't rain. This is dope. Or do you not think so far? Hey. Sick. And here we got Frank Ocean's most critically acclaimed song, Pyramids. Bubbles in my champagne, let it be some jazz playing. Top floor motel suite, twisting my cigars, working at the pyramid. Working at the Pyramids is 9 minutes and 53 seconds of pure glory. It makes sense then that the opening sequence and underlying piano progression is reminiscent of church choir at the climax of its performance. And while the instrumentals themselves are spiritual, it's really Ocean's unparalleled storytelling abilities that give Pyramids its crown. This one has to go to popular for me. I do enjoy both of them. I haven't heard any of the full songs. I know Frank Ocean is very iconic. I'm gonna put these albums on my playlist right now. Here we got Drake and his most popular song, One Dance. Grips on your ways, front way, back way. You know that I don't play. Street's not safe, but I never run away. Even when I'm away. OT, OT, there's never much love when we go OT. I pray to make it back in one piece. I think this song is just a masterpiece. It's so minimalistic. It works so well with his singing. It's just incredibly catchy. Let me know in the comments what rappers feel about Drake. I think he's a little bit hated, but he's also the biggest artist in the world. I need a one dance, got a Hennessy in my hand. One more time before I go. Higher powers taking a hold on me. Why does it work so well? There's no bass, and you just have the piano that just plays almost nothing. Boom, boom. And it just works. It grooves so hard, it doesn't feel like anything's missing. That is genius production. And here we got Drake's most critically acclaimed song, Hotline Bling. What? You used to call me on my cell phone. I mean, it's a good, catchy song. I felt like this song mainly got big because of the music video and his dad dancing, but it is really catchy. He actually sings really good in this one. I know when that hotline bling, It's like a little bit more punch to it. Ever since I left the city, you. Like that is dope. Like usually it's all like, you used to grab me, well. But then in this song, he's like, ever since I left the city, you. There's more punch to it. I like it. For someone who keeps his finger on the pulse so successfully, it should be impossible to identify a career-topping song. But if Drake has one, we all know it's Hotline Bling. More so than One Dance. I'm very torn. I'm gonna have to give 1 point to each this time. I love Hotline Bling as well. I realized while I was listening to it, I've just been thinking about it as a meme, but it's a very good song. Here we got U2 with their most popular song, With or Without You. Through the storm, we reach the shore. Young Bono. You gave it all, but I want more. With or without you. Why is it moving so weirdly? I feel like I've had too much apple juice. Creepy Bono is staring at me and like everything's moving weird. I feel like I'm in a scenario I don't want to be in. I'm not crazy about that song. It's very slow, kind of predictable. It's good songwriting for sure, but it's just one of those songs that would have been better if it was 20 BPM faster or something. And then we got U2's most critically acclaimed song, One. Is it getting better? Or do you feel the same? This vocal is way better. Will it make it easier on you now? One love, one life. Yeah, way better. When it's one need in the night. I think he does like falsetto flips on purpose, like voice cracks. One love. Not that extreme. And they keep those takes. That's interesting. Leaves you, baby. I'm gonna have to give it 2-1. Critics have it. Here we got Justin Timberlake and his most popular song, Can't Stop the Feeling.
Swedish songwriters, by the way. I got this feeling inside my bones.
It goes electric wavy when I turn it on. I don't know about music videos with random people dancing anymore, man. I guess it works. Happy and This had pretty much the same concept. We were talking about another music video in a video, I think yesterday or 2 days ago, that had a similar concept as well. It's very popular now, just random people dancing. Under the lights when everything goes. Nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. So just imagine, just imagine. Hey, oh, those donuts look good though. It's such a good song. There's so much to love about this production. Like the swelling pads that just lie there and they feel so atmospheric and nice on this very rhythmic freaking melody and just the groove of the bass and the drums. So good. I'm not crazy about how like squeaky and high that falsetto is, but definitely like, oh yeah, this song is called Can't Stop the Feeling, which is something I appreciate in songwriting. Can't stop the feeling! I don't know, man. Just not the best registry for most people. And here we got Justin Timberlake's most critically acclaimed song, Mirrors. This is a messy production. Like, there's no impact in anything in this song. It's a choice, I think so. Like, there's a lot of layered beatboxing and stuff. I don't know, it doesn't do it for me. There's no punch. Kind of pitchy vocals on and off on this. I think the lyrics are nice. The biggest thing that's set in my heart is the space and now you're home. It's like you're my mirror. Very sad and cute music video though. That really lifts it up to another level. Everything great about Justin Timberlake's The 2020 Experience is captured on Mirrors, which for me is the greatest pop single, not just of this year, but the decade. Okay, Dan Lucas, hard to disagree. I'm gonna give it to Popular. I think Can't Stop the Feeling is the type of feel-good song that no music critic will ever say, like, this is great. It needs to be a little bit of a sentimental shift in it, like with Teenage Dream or something, some nostalgia or whatever, for critics to be excited. That is my very informed take. I have read every review of every song ever. Okay guys, click here for more music VS videos, click here for music commentary videos, and today's winner is critically acclaimed. Can you believe it? This critic agrees with critics. Okay guys, I will see you tomorrow in another daily video. Take care everybody. I'm gonna go drink water. With my butt!